Melanie so much, don't you?
What, sitting in the back of a taxi?
No. Just knowing that in half an hour we are going to be inside a hot, sweaty club where the kids have gone there to do exactly the same thing.
What do you mean? It's going to be exciting, isn't it?
Never know what's going to happen, but always know it's going to be good.
Expectation.
Exactly. I love it. It gets me every time.
Salutations, my friends. Welcome to Club Le Monde, the best club in town. A club where the bar staff are polite.
Piss off!
And the bouncers are friendly.
Fucking stay out, you little bastard!
The atmosphere is convivial. And of course, I make loads of... dosh. Actually, I've got to tell you, this is my dream job. There's nothing I would better prefer to be doing. Now, I started promoting nights back in the mid-80s, you know, a little bit of hip, a little bit of hot, northern soul, rare groove, that kind of thing. But, I mean, when the acid has been coming on, I mean, it totally blew me away. A few films, a few tents, a few thousand coppers. Well, just then, when it was starting to get a little bit hairy, I found this place. I thought, there ain't no cowpats here. This is the future. So I made a lot of calls, went to a lot of meetings. I put together a consortium of stockbroker friends of mine, put an offering on this place. What can I say? I've been living the dream ever since. Angela, you look ravishing.
Well, ravish me, why don't you?
Well, come here then and I will. I read a thing the other day that said that kids in the 90s would rather go clubbing than have sex.
Oh.
Well, that's fucking great, isn't it? Hey.
We're on the guest list.
So?
So we'd like to get in.
So you'd like to go to the back of the queue, just like everyone else?
No, 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 we're on the guest list.
That's the guest list queue.
Where's the non-guest list queue?
You're standing in it. Go on now if you want. Costs you 15 quid, though.
You're joking.
So it's not like I'm fucking joking.
Come on, let's just go to the back.
Fucking moron, but he thinks he's really hard.
Fucking moron. But he thinks he's really hard.
Now I remember why I stopped going clubbing. It's all run by morons.
Nah. You stopped going clubbing because you couldn't handle other people chatting at you.
No, I didn't. Yeah, you did.
I did not. So how come whenever she went away, you used to get off your trolley?
It's coincidence.
Coincidence, bollocks. Makes me say you don't want to shag.
I'm trying to get one of those the last month.
So how you feeling? You all right?
I don't know. It's kind of weird. It's kind of exciting. It's kind of scary. It's kind of sad. It's lots of things, really. I'm glad I'm doing it now.
Yeah, there comes a point you need to start getting on with your life again.
Exactly.
So do you feel ready to go for anyone else yet?
I'm not sure, really. No, I've got to think of that for a while.
How old are you two, then?
19.
Yeah? Well, you don't look it. When's your birthdays?
23rd of October, 1974.
Wasn't born yesterday, you know. So you're both 19. You're both on the list. Go ahead then. In you go.
You said, sorry, I wasn't thinking. I haven't done this kind of thing before. Just let me do the talking, okay?
Okay. Hi, we're on the guest list.
Which one?
John's.
John's?
Yeah. John Clark?
You have to be a bit more specific than that, love. Big John, Little John, Good Kisser John, or John who used to be Jane John?
Big John, I suppose.
Big John, you suppose? Now, which Big John do you suppose that might be? Big John the hippie, Big John the skinhead, Big Yo-Yo Jojo John, Big Hello John, Got a New Motor John, Big City John, or Big Premature Ejaculation John?
Big Premature Ejaculation John, actually.
Hang on a sec. What's the name?
Patrick and Anthony. I'm his brother.
You're Big Premature Ejaculation John's brother. It don't run in the family, does it?
Well, when I say brother, I mean half-brother, really. It's not known on my mother's side, so nothing like that at all, no. I mean, all my friends, they call me Karen Cumming Patrick, because I can just carry on and on.
No, they don't. Shut up.
They do, actually.
Yeah, well, anyway, that's £5, please. Carry on coming, Patrick.
But I thought we were on the VIP guest list.
Yeah, you are. You're on the IP guest list, which means important person, which means you still have to pay £5 to get in. Now, if you're on the VIP guest list, that'd be different. You get in for free. And if you were really important, like very VIP, you get free drinks tokens as well. But you're really not that important, so that's £5, please. Oh, don't worry. You're still young. You'll make it onto the VIP list sometime.
He's fucking deaf! I said no one's getting in till he's all take 3 steps back!
Apparently, it's the only recognised career route for becoming a contract killer.
What? Being a bouncer?
Really?
Yeah. You start off as a bouncer, then if you liked, you get into a bit of protection work. You know, breaking people's arms and legs and stuff. Then if you're still liked after that, and you're still alive, of course, you get asked to kill a few people. And once you've done that, your name gets around and you go freelance.
Oh, sounds all right, doesn't it?
Well paid, do some travelling. Yeah, I suppose so. Meet some interesting people.
Yeah, although we'd probably have to kill half of them.
Yeah, that'd be a bit of a downer, really.
Yeah, although not as much as a downer as being killed.
Chunda!
What's happening, geezer? Mike, you all right?
All right, Chunda, you?
Yeah, yeah, wicked, man, wicked. So it's going to be a top night, yeah? We all sorted?
Who do you think you're talking to? Of course we're sorted.
Yeah, a couple of easy.
Hey, nice one, top one, well scored, boys.
Yeah, Durwood's finest. We're going to be boxed.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Told you I'd get us in.
Yeah, you said you'd get us in for free.
Yeah, well, it's a happening night.
It's empty. Give it a chance. Nothing really starts until about 11:30.
Wow, that's when everything closes in Tunbridge Wells.
Yeah, well, you're in London now.
Why do we spend the last hour queuing up outside in the freezing cold when there's no one inside?
Just the way things are done, don't it, really?
Seems pretty stupid to me.
I'm sure there's a good reason for it, Anthony.
I just don't have any late to do tonight.
What? Just lose it completely?
Sure.
You might not.
Well, you've been through some pretty rough emotions recently.
Which is why I want to lose it, just to forget them and blank them out for a change. Oh, God, I haven't lost it completely in such a long time.
Yeah, remember the last time you did? You spent the whole night pouring water over that gay guy's head because you thought his hair was on fire.
Right, I'll get it. Maybe lay off the acid and just get really fucked.
No, pissed.
Shit-faced.
Rat-arsed.
Bollocks.
Millard.
Wanker. Cunty. Jackie! That's a disgusting word.
Yeah, it isn't it? God, am I sitting there right being all slappers.
I still can't believe you and Ali split up. She was a rocking girl, man, really cool. What happened?
Oh, you know how it is.
No, not really. What happened?
No, I don't really want to talk about it.
Oh, yeah, come on, man, it's good to talk. She split up with you, didn't she?
No.
But she did.
No, she didn't.
So did you miss her then?
I said I don't want to talk about it.
But I thought you loved her.
I said I don't want to talk about it, all right?
Do you reckon you might get it back together?
Chonda, I don't want to fucking talk about it.
I was only trying to help.
Yeah, well, I don't need it.
So when you split up, did you cry?
We went to all that trouble for nothing. They didn't even search us.
Better safe than sorry, eh?
Yeah.
Take my drink. Take my drink. Well, take my fucking drink, man. It's all right.
Chaz, you're scaring me.
It's okay, it was okay.
What are you doing? Fucking hell! Got your nipple pierced!
Yep.
That's excellent.
Yeah?
That is so... Why didn't you tell me?
Well, that was a surprise, wasn't it? I was going to show you later on.
Ah, that is so sweet. Where'd you get it done?
Did it myself.
Oh, my God. Didn't it hurt?
Eh? Nah, see, I used a frozen beef burger to numb my nipple. Didn't feel a thing. Although, no, I think I might have blacked out for a while because I do remember waking up on the kitchen floor. I'm not really sure how I got there, but apart from that, nah, didn't hurt at all.
How did you do it?
Borrowed a sewing needle off my gran.
Your gran?
Yeah.
Did she mind?
No, she thought it was really funny.
So, how did you do it?
I sterilised the needle with my granddad's lighter and then I cooled it with an ice cube and just skewered it right through. Yeah. Nearly did me cock as well, but I just couldn't bring myself to put the needle through, you know.
I'll do it for you.
Yeah, will you?
Yeah. It's a real turn on. It's always been a major fantasy to get fucked by a guy with a pierced dick.
Hey, you never told me.
I don't tell you everything.
I've read when you come, all the sperm's pink, you know, because of the blood and that, and it just shoots everywhere because of all the holes.
Ah, let me do it!
I don't know.
Oh, God. on, it'd be a right laugh.
Let me think about it.
Okay, but I just want to tell you this. I swear I'll be really careful.
It's pretty dead in here as well.
As I said, it's still early. Do you want a drink?
Sure.
What do you want?
I'll just have a beer.
A beer?
Yeah.
You can't have a beer.
Why not?
Because I'm only doing some E.
So?
Well, you just don't drink beer when you take an E.
Why not?
Well, you're at a club. No one drinks alcohol at a club. It's just really uncool.
Well, they're drinking beer.
They're losers.
Yeah, but you drink beer.
Look, Anthony, it's really complicated, okay? Just trust me. You don't drink a drug at the same time. It doesn't work and it's dangerous.
Well, what shall I have then?
Water.
I can get that from the tap.
Look, Anthony, I'm trying to make things easy for you, okay? You've never been to a club before. I have. You've never taken E before. I have. Everyone drinks water, so you drink water and that's that.
Okay, fine, I'll have a pint of water.
Don't smell as bad as I thought.
5 quid.
That's outrageous.
Do you want them or not?
She's a bit rude, isn't she?
Yeah, she wouldn't get a job as a barmaid in Tunbridge Wells, that's for sure.
Oh, who's Chanda talking to? Same girl he's been talking to since he got here.
So?
So? What?
So don't you think we've done enough talking?
So?
So? So do you want to come back to mine?
What?
I've got this big king-size bed and it gets awfully lonely sometimes all by myself.
What? Now? What about a dance?
Yeah, what they say about dancing. Fuck dancing, let's.
Yeah. Fuck dancing. Let's drink some coffee.
Yeah, if you like.
Wicked, I like a good cup of coffee, I do.
I hope you like more than one.
Yeah. Coffee keeps me up all night, you know what I mean? Yeah. You got the sugar, babe, I got the cream. Well, it's been a great night, boys. Good laugh and everything. And I am sorry about Ali, Mike, I really am. But I'm going back to her.
Sarah,
nice one. Sarah's bad. So I'll catch you boys later, yeah? Wicked.
See ya.
Coca-cocaine. It's the best, isn't it?
Yeah, do you know what I like most about it?
What?
The name.
Who?
Charlie. It's my all-time favourite. When I have a kid, that's what I'm going to call him.
You're going to name your kid after a drug?
Yeah. I prefer Henry, really, but there aren't any drugs called Henry. So I reckon I'll just stick with Charlie.
Can't get over Chanda. Such a wet dream. She was total babesville.
Yeah, why doesn't that kind of thing have happened to me?
It did, Mike. That's why you're no longer in your 5-year pretty good relationship. You're pretty nice, pretty hot girl.
Nah, yeah, well, it's only ever happened once.
How many times do you want it to happen?
I don't know. All the time?
It's up to you, isn't it?
Yeah, well, when me and Ali were going out, right, sometimes I really wanted to be single again. Now I'm single, I remember one of the reasons why I always wanted to be in a relationship is because I'm crap at chatting up girls.
So what? You want to go back out with her?
Oh, I don't know, really. Sometimes I think I do, and sometimes I think I don't.
All right, then. He's all in now.
Fuck, here's Mike.
Fuck.
Michael!
Look, I've still got some of that wine that I nicked from the office party. We can go back to the flat if you want. No, fuck it, let's stay. Ali, look, you don't have to act all tough in front of me.
No, I know, but...
All the times that we go out, and all the times that blokes would chat me up, and you get so fucking jealous, Jackie, for no reason, because I was so faithful. Tonight, what I'm going to do? I'm going to repay him for all the pain and hurt and depression that he's put me through in the last month. And I'm going to make him so fucking jealous and so fucking sick inside he's going to want to die.
That's so amazing. Ali, I'm proud to be your friend.
How are you going to do that?
Snogging tons of blokes. Totally sure.
Yes. Gonna be a filthy, dirty, slutty, slaggy slapper and love every second of it.
Slut slapper?
Slut slapper! Slapper! Slapper!
I'm not talking about you, are I?
Fuck off.
Sarah, wait. It was a joke.
Why do we have to queue for every fucking thing in this country?
Shit, fat piss.
Count my bastard. Ah!
I knew I was doing something tomorrow. I can't believe it. I'll get up at 6 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Why?
My parents are picking me up. Gary's getting married.
What, your cousin Gary? You sold?
Yeah, fucking forgot all about it.
Is he nice then?
Not especially.
Well, why'd you snog him?
I was pissed.
That's not like you.
Oh, champagne. The shade's mine.
Champagne? How come you was drinking champagne?
It's his engagement party.
You snogged your cousin at his engagement party?
Yeah.
Well, didn't his fiancée mind?
Nah, she passed out by then.
I'm sorry, but there's a queue. You have to go to the back like everyone else.
I don't care if there's a queue. I've had my credit cards nicked. I've had 50 quid nicked. I've had the keys to my house and my car nicked. I ain't gonna come back tomorrow and find out my coat's been nicked as well. My ticket was in my bag, which was stolen from your club. I ain't in a good mood right now. I need to go home, change my locks, so no scum can come and burgle me.
If you haven't got your ticket, you can't pick up your coat until the end of the evening. I'm sorry.
This is ridiculous. I want to speak to your manager now.
I think he's busy for the night, but I'll try.
You are totally, what? Totally gorgeous. You know that, don't you?
Come on.
Oh, fucking technology. Sorry, babe. I have to pick it out. I thought I told you I didn't want to be interrupted.
You better come and have a look for it then.
Thank you.
Excuse me.
Ticket?
Oh, sorry. Yeah, it's here somewhere.
Oh, come on, I haven't got all night.
Here she is, 322.
Any luck yet?
No.
Here you go.
Thanks.
Here it is. Wait. What make is it? Ashy.
Get up. Sweet.
Shit, I know her. Went to college with her. She's a liar, a thief, a whore, really unpleasant.
So you used to be quite good friends then?
Oh, well, we did actually. Till I found out she was slagging me off to my boyfriend. Bitch.
What'd you do?
Not much. Just kicked her head in behind the union one night.
See, that's what I should have done with Mike. Give him a good smacking.
I ripped his bollocks off.
Dropped his willy off.
Excuse me, love. Couldn't help overhearing your conversation. You've been to Africa, yeah?
No.
Oh. Well, that's good, because neither have I, but some of my mates say they've just gone out there, and I was going to go with them, but in the end, I just thought, fuck it, it's just a big desert, innit? I mean, I'd prefer to spend the money on some new togs and some decent pills and shit. Just next couple, a few minutes ago, actually. Can't feel anything yet. Got stopped by this cop car. Had to chuck them down in case they searched us. Been done once for Class A possession before. Don't much fancy being done again.
Wow, you sound like a really crazy guy.
Oh, crazy baby, yeah. Always up for it. Nutter I am. Complete nutter.
Is that why you're wearing sunglasses after dark? Because you're a complete nutter and you don't care what people think?
Yeah.
Right. Oh! Give me a bubble.
Oh, I've grown bigger, but yeah. You're a couple of party chicks. Let's all hook up inside later on.
You could kiss him.
Sorry?
Are you a good kisser?
Who's asking?
If you took your bloody sunglasses off, you'd be able to see, wouldn't you?
Yeah. I could lodge it up on the old tongue action. Oh, are you up for it, then?
Depends who's asking.
Fuck!
Oof, this really is horrid. I'm definitely not drinking anymore.
When we start tripping, I bet you'll be drinking it then.
Who are you going to get the drugs from?
The dealer, stupid.
A drugs dealer?
No, an antiques dealer. Of course a bloody drugs dealer.
Wow, I'm going to meet a drugs dealer. Excellent.
That's £2, please.
What?
£2, please.
You're putting them on the same hanger?
Yeah, it's a pumper jacket. That's £2, please.
Yeah, but you're putting them on the same hanger. If it's only taking the space of one jacket, it should be £1.
No, that's not how it works. It's a pound per jacket, not per hanger. If it makes it fit any better, I can put them on two hangers.
No, that's not the point. I don't want them to go on two hangers. I want them to go on one hanger and pay £1 for one hanger.
Look, you've got two jackets. It's £1 per jacket per ticket. That's what the sign says, and that's £2. Now, you can either take your coats if you want to, or you can pay. It's up to you. Thank you.
Bad news, mate. Bad news.
Let's go and score.
Score?
Find some aid.
Is it true all drug dealers are black?
Some are, some aren't. Just depends, really.
So how do you know a drug dealer when you see one?
Well, in the past, I generally found they were shifty but confident, anti-authoritarian, kind of casual insouciance about them.
All right, well, that shouldn't be too hard to spot, then.
God, you're a moron sometimes. Look, it's not a problem. We'll get some here. How fucking hell are you going to take me dodgy? Are you some dodgy dealer? He used to do it all the time before Matt Deward.
Yeah, but that was years ago when everyone was in it for a laugh and got pissed off if they thought it was shit. It's different now.
Oh, it's not that different. Come on, what chance it?
No, I'm not gonna.
Oh, come on.
No.
I thought you wanted to get completely wasted.
Yeah, so we just get pissed.
Where's your money for the fucking ease?
Yo, motherfucker, motherfuckers. What's happening, my man? I'm down on the ground looking for some of your baddest drive-by dope shit. What's the damage, Holmes?
Fuck off.
Your brother's respect.
Someone of your king size, Kelly's Kelly.
Yeah. You got her up in one.
Kelly!
Up in one, up in one, up in one.
Do I have to?
Up in one, up in one, up in one.
Oh, I don't have to
up
really,
in one,
do
up
I?
In one, up in one. Up in one.
Well, come on, it's not loud.
Oh, God, all right. Up in one, up in one, up in one. Up in one, up in one, up in one. Up in one, up in one, up in one.
Okay, but I still don't see why they told you to fuck off if they weren't annoyed with you.
They're hardcore, man. They're not pissed off for me, they're pissed off for life. I mean, their sisters are probably prostitutes, their mother's on crack, and their best friend's just been wasted in some fucked up drug deal. We're talking real people, Anthony. Not people who go to public school and learn Latin, you know. We're talking hardcore criminals. I mean, right now, I bet they're planning the revenge murder of their best friend.
Fancy dancing, not especially.
Well, if you think you can do any better, why don't you score?
Okay.
What?
I said okay.
Okay?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, but you've got to promise me one thing.
What?
That you won't tell my parents?
Emily, I've never even met your parents.
Come on, baby. Yippee! Chunda! Chunda!
Okay, mate, in you go.
Cheers. See you later, girls.
Bye.
Look, I said if she's there, I'll come back and pay, but if not, I've got to go on somewhere else. I promise I won't be more than 10 minutes.
Give us 15 quid, you can go on for as long as you want.
But that's the whole point. She's got my money, which is why I need to see her.
Tough.
All right, you keep these if I don't come back.
Oh, Cliff fucking Richard. Piss off, mate.
They're my sisters, but... All right. My jacket.
Mate, I wouldn't touch it with a barge pole.
Keys? Car keys?
What car have you got?
Porsche.
What type?
928.
Colour?
Black with silver go faster stripes down the side.
Forget it.
Saw you driving past any yellow Morris Minor.
My other car's a Porsche.
Yeah, no, fucking Sylvester Stallone.
Well, you know, you do look a little like him, I have to say.
Do I?
First thing I thought when I saw you.
Yeah?
But you must get that all the time. No. What about my waistcoat? I bought this today for £150.
Turn round. So, do you really think I look like Stallone?
Yeah, I wouldn't fuck about with a thing like that, not me.
All right, then, 10 minutes. You're not back in 10 minutes, this waistcoat's mine, all right?
Deal.
Hey, Nessie. What do you think of this?
It's not yours, is it?
No, but it will be in 7 minutes and 30 seconds. Do you think? Not that good at clothes. My mum buys most of mine for me.
Your mum?
Yeah.
What, your socks and underwear and stuff?
No, everything. Stop laughing.
I'm not.
Yeah, well, don't. I like it when people laugh at me.
I'm not mush. Honest.
So why shouldn't my mum buy me clothes for me?
No, that's great. I think it's really sweet. It's really sweet. It's nice.
You're taking the piss.
I'm not.
Yeah, you are.
Mosh, I'm not, honest. Everyone's mum buys them clothes. Mine does.
Does she?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I just don't like people taking the piss out of me or me mum.
I wasn't.
Yeah, well, don't. So, do you like it?
Yes. It's all right. I don't think it's your colour, though.
So, you don't like it?
No, it's lovely. I just don't think it says... Mosh.
His nipples, his dick. Both, actually.
Very nice.
15, 14, 13, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7.
6 seconds later, that would have been yours. But luckily, it's not. And it's mine.
It's not my colour anyway, mate.
Yeah, I'm okay, I suppose. What about you?
Yeah, I'm really good, thanks.
Right. What are you doing here?
I've come to snog as many good-looking men as I can, maybe even take a couple of moments. You don't know anyone that's up for a cheap shag, do you? Well, apart from yourself, of course, but you don't care. Oh, well. Nice to bump into you. See you soon, I'm sure. Oh, you're looking very handsome tonight, Steve.
Thanks.
I'm going to the bar.
She's well fucked off.
Well, wouldn't you be?
Yeah. Yeah, of course. She's got a right to be. I think maybe we should get together. You know, try and sort things out.
Oh, that's really sweet of you.
I mean, they've got so many things they still need to talk about. If we can help them get together.
Well, fuck that. Not them, us.
God, you can be such a selfish little prick sometimes, you know that? Look, we've already been through this. We had intercourse. We were pissed. It lasted about 2 seconds, and you spent the whole night farting and snoring. Did you really think that's an experience that I want to repeat again?
It'll be better this time.
Frankly, it couldn't get any worse.
It's all right now, but when I did it, like cracks, you know, like when you put the needle through. Like...
Excuse me, can it help overhearing your conversation? You're American, yeah?
No.
Huh? Are you?
No.
Fuck me. Oh, must be really losing it. I'm tripping my nuts off. That's it. I got this joke, yeah. This Russian guy goes.
Nah.
This guy goes up to this girl, yeah, and says, are you Russian? And she says, no, I'm American. It's my favourite name. Anyway, I'll see you later.
Yeah, all right, mate.
What a twat.
In the mic 10 minutes ago, wanted to check out the chicks and get some serious casual sex.
Really want to know?
Well, of course.
His ex-girlfriend turned up. Made him realise that although he always thought if he was ever single again, he'd be having tons of one-night stands. He's not. Never has done, he never will do, because... No, I don't know, it's just not in my nature.
Bollocks.
It's true.
Why not? You're a good-looking guy.
So what?
So all the girls go for you. You're funny, you're interesting, you're well turned out. You're a stud.
You're a fucking porno star. Your balls are on fire and you've got a big hard dick ready to rock and roll.
I wouldn't say I got a big dick.
Hey, don't put yourself down. I'm a guy, I know these things. You definitely got a big dick. If I was a girl, I'd want to get my hands on it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
When you been looking at my dick?
What?
When have you been looking at my dick?
Well, I don't make a habit of it, but you know, in the toilet sometimes.
I can't believe you.
It's not a gay thing. You know, when you've got nothing better to do.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Anyway, I think your dick's bigger than mine.
Nah, mine's definitely average compared to yours.
I've seen it, I think it's pretty big.
What have you seen my dick? I don't know, in the toilets, I suppose, when you weren't looking at mine. And when you're looking, do you look at other guys' dicks or just mine?
Oh, yeah, others as well. What about you?
Oh, everyone's really.
Yeah, me too.
And being honest here, yours does compare pretty favourably to others.
Well, thanks, so does yours.
So, hey, we both got big dicks.
Cool!
Can I have 2 half-pints of lager, please? 2 double shots of vodka in the same glass.
In the same glass? You sure?
Yeah.
So you want a pint of lager with a quadruple vodka discharge?
No, I want 2 half-pints of lager each with 2 double vodkas.
So you don't want it all in the same glass?
No, I want it in 2 glasses.
So why did you say you wanted it all in one glass in the first place?
I didn't say I wanted it.
You're being awkward.
No, I'm not.
Do you think I haven't got anything better to do than stand here talking to you?
No, I didn't mean
it. Do you think I enjoy working here till 4 o'clock every morning?
I don't.
Do you think I actually enjoy listening to that disgusting noise every weekend? Sorry, Bob, what was it you wanted again?
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Hello there, I'm Anthony, and I'd like some ecstasy, please.
You'd like some ecstasy, please?
Some E.
Some E?
If that's okay.
How many do you want?
2.
What kind?
Doves,
snowballs, rhubarb and custards, beef burgers, strawberries. Capsules, pills? You ever done E before?
Not really, no.
That's all right. Not a problem. I know just the thing. You wait here, yeah? Be back in a minute, kid.
OK, I'll stay right here.
All right, Don. You got any duds left?
Yeah, of course. How many want?
Just a couple. square up later, yeah?
Guys, oh, sweet.
Oh, cock and I, you won't stop partying until tomorrow night.
Wow, great, that's exactly what we wanted. Looks a bit like Disprin to me.
What are you saying? You saying I'm fucking Dudsky?
Sorry?
You saying I'm dealing duds?
Oh, no, not at all. I was just... I was just making a casual observation.
If I were you, I'd keep your fucking casual observations to yourself, mate. Some geezers aren't as friendly as me. Wouldn't take too kindly to hearing that kind of shit. You know what I mean?
I'm sorry, I just thought that they...
Forget it. I'm just telling you for your own good. Personally, I don't care. It's 30 quid.
Here you are.
Nice one, mate.
Nice one yourself, matey. Thank you very much.
Fucking hell.
Fucking nightmare. Andy and Tony are both running sick. It's total chaos.
Are you by yourself, then?
Fucking puffs.
There's nothing the mighty mush can't handle, do I?
Yeah, I suppose not. Where did you go, mate?
Cheers, mate. Go on.
Oi. Who's she?
It's Lizzie. It's one of Jan's mates. Like queen fag egg pain in the arse. But there you go. No one's perfect. See you later, mate.
See you, mate. You 18?
He said we'd be partying till tomorrow night. Drugs.
I love them.
Yeah, nice one, mate. Cheers.
Oh, God. That's gross.
Yeah, it's a good sign. The worse the taste, the better they are.
What the fuck are they looking at?
The men are all the same, aren't they? They give it out to the cows, come home and expect you to take it lying down with your legs open. But then when you give it back, just that little bit, they can't fucking take it, can they?
No, but that's why we're the strongest edits, because we have to put up with it all the time.
Yeah. Like, come on, let's do this.
What, all that?
Yeah. Why not?
OK.
1, 2, 3, go. OK. Watch this.
You know, she French kissed you.
Have it all the time, you're on drugs. It's all part of the buzz, man.
Wow.
Now, she's pretty cute. What about her?
Yeah, it's not bad.
What do I say, Steve? How do I chat a girl up?
Well, you just say whatever comes in your head.
No, it's a problem. Nothing ever does.
It doesn't matter what you say, really. It can be something really crap, really mundane, just as long as it gets you talking. Then when you're talking, you're rolling.
So what do I say?
Well, I don't know. Have you got the time?
Oh, not that fucking sad. No, I can think of something a bit better than that, thank you very much.
Go on, you've got to. She made the first move and it's like she's daring you to make the second.
Do you really think so?
Yeah, go on, Pat. She's an older woman. She must be at least 23. Think of all the experience she's had.
She thinks she's wearing a really sexy French underwear.
Yeah, of course. That's what older women wear.
Now, my brother.
Your brother Ian?
Yeah.
Well, apparently his mate's done his nose in so much that the only way he can do coke now is by shoving it up his bum.
Up his bum?
Yeah.
Ew, that's gross. What, with his fingers?
I suppose so.
What if he'd done a really big line and he had to do a poo?
Well, if you got a poo, you got poo, ain't you?
Yeah. So if you were doing a line with him, do you reckon you'd have to shove some up your bum as well? Just, you know, just to be polite.
Well, maybe. Or maybe you'd have to shove it up each other's bum.
Ew, what if he was constipated?
It'd be really hard thing, wouldn't it?
Or what if he had diarrhea? That'd be really messy, wouldn't it?
Yeah. I don't think I'd fancy much doing a line with him, would you?
Definitely not.
Excuse me. I was just wondering whether you knew what. Have you got the time, please?
Do I look like I've got the time?
I suppose not.
Do you really want to know what time it is?
Not really, no.
So why did you ask?
I thought we could have sex.
Look, just because I'm really pretty and I've got a really nice body and I choose to express myself in a really sexual way doesn't mean I'm completely gagging for it.
Oh, sorry, I thought you were.
Well, does that make you feel any better?
No.
Well, was that a good snog, at least?
A bit too much of St. Bernard for my liking.
Hi, I'm Patrick. I think you're a really great kisser. My dad's a merchant banker, so's my brother. That's what I want to be when I grow up. That is, if my music career doesn't take off. I'm in a band. The singer. The lead singer. I sing you a song, but we've only written two, and they're both instrumentals. But, you know, guitar music's pretty dead nowadays. I'm thinking of breaking up the band and forming my own underground left-field techno outfit. In my bedroom. So, I was wondering if I could interest you ladies in a drink.
Fuck off.
I'm sorry, it's just, sorry. You're right. We've arranged to meet up afterwards.
Wow.
Well, as I said, it's no big deal. It's all part of the drugs buzz, man.
Wow.
This never would have happened. I fucking spent the whole night trying not to be chatted up by sweaty, smelly, ugly oiks, and I hate it. I've had a crap time, and I'm never coming to a straight club ever again.
Oh, Jesus, Lizzie. If you don't want to get noticed, you shouldn't prance about wearing next to nothing.
Well, that's a fucking typical comment from a heterosexual male like you, isn't it, Mark? My gay friends wouldn't dare tell me what I can and can't do or how to dress. I think you're so fucking great, but let me tell you something, Mark. Gay men are better looking, they dress better, dance better, they've got a better sense of humour, and they're better in bed. In fact, you know what? I wish all men were gay, and I wish they liked women as well.
What, guys? Want some puffers?
Yeah, awesome. Cheers, mate.
Weird, innit?
What?
Lie.
No, it just doesn't edit.
Yeah, that's what it's supposed to do, innit? It fuck you up. I don't care what it is, mate, as long as it fucks me up, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, do you want to know what's really weird?
What?
When you're going out with someone, you go to a club with them, you spend the whole night wishing they weren't there, okay? When they're not there, you spend the whole night wishing that they were. And then when you stop going out of them all together, you spend the whole time wondering whether there's anyone else you prefer to be going out with than the person you just split up with.
Yeah, anyway, see you later, guys.
Fucking twat. Look at you. You're a fucking twat as well.
Do you know what pisses me off most about being a bouncer?
Everyone hates you?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm the last about that.
What then?
Well, people think you're like, you know, you're dead fucking thick.
No, oh, you're not stupid, are you?
No, no, but to the old levels as it goes.
Well, that's great.
Yeah, I was dead chuffed. Nessa?
Yeah?
If I tell you something, do you promise you won't laugh?
Yeah, of course.
You promise you won't tell anyone else?
Of course not, what is it?
Well, I've been thinking about going back to college.
That's great. That's really good.
Yeah? Do you think so?
Yeah, definitely. What are you thinking of studying?
Well, I was thinking maybe the law, because I wouldn't mind becoming a lawyer.
I think you've got a lot of tension and pent-up anger inside you, haven't you, Lizzie? It's okay to admit it. We all have.
Yeah, I do.
And I don't think you like it too much, do you?
No.
The Would you feel like you'd like to get it out of your system? I mean, for good. Forever.
Yeah, I would.
Because I think I can help you.
Really? How?
By coming in your mouth.
Oh, great.
Two
tequilas
and two
lagers,
please.
Me again? You're going to be nice to me this time.
I don't want to be nice to you.
I don't know, it just makes things a bit easier.
For you, maybe, but not for me.
For the both of us. To try and make this as amicable as possible.
Fuck you, Mike. You put your dick inside another woman. And what did you think you were doing with her? But you'd be even amicable? Were you going to get married? I was going to have your children. You actually expect me to be nice to you? Me. You smashed me into little fucking pieces. I hate you. I fucking hate you.
Hey. On the edge. I don't like seeing people upset.
Thanks.
Lizzie, what? Mark's got something to say to you, haven't he, Mark?
Yeah, I have, actually. I'm sorry about what I said before.
You were really out of order, Mark. You really hurt me, you know?
Yeah, I know. As I said, I don't know what I was thinking. I would never want to come in your mouth, Lizzie, because I think you're an ugly, hairy, stuck-up little bull dyke. Yeah, I think you probably fancy Jan. And even if you begged me to have a threesome with the pair of you, I would still say no, because that is how much I like you.
You know what, Mark? You're right. I do fancy Jan.
You know what I said about a threesome? I didn't mean it.
Where the beers? Just bumped into Elliot at the bar and had a massive argument, so I didn't get any.
Not again. Oh, it's so weird. In the last few weeks, my emotions have been so heightened. I just want to go around telling everyone how much I love them. It's like being on E.
Really?
Yeah.
So have you told anyone yet?
Not yet, no.
You could tell me.
Yeah, I could do.
Do you want to?
Well, yeah, I suppose so.
Go on, then.
What, now?
Why not?
Okay. I love you, Steve.
I love you too, Mike. You're my best mate.
Thanks.
Come here.
Have you done this kind of thing before?
Well, I have slept with other women, yeah, but I'd like to reassure you, Jan, that in no way am I a lesbian, because I do like men, but just not all the time.
I see, I think.
Are you okay about this? Because I don't want to rush you.
Well, I wouldn't mind talking about it a little bit more if you don't mind.
Your place or mine.
Here comes trouble. Girls. Girls, are you sure you've come to the right night?
Bonsoir, monsieur. Nous nous présentons pour la fête de Izzy.
Sorry, love, wrong place.
Stupid fucking cow. I told you she wouldn't have a party in a shithole like this.
David, darling, do let's just go in. I could murder a pint.
Yeah, I suppose so. We're never gonna find it now.
Sorry, girls, I'm full.
We did not come here to discuss your eating habits, fatty.
Sorry, boys, the club's full. You'll have to take your high heels and your handbag somewhere else.
Oh, so who stole your underpants, piss pot?
So go on, piss off.
Oh, God. Girls, you stupid fucking tart! You brought us to the wrong fucking club again!
And the nice young brain hemorrhage won't let us in.
Oh, that's not a problem. Leave it to me, girl.
How are you feeling?
Fine.
Is anything happening yet?
No, not really. How about you?
I don't think so, no. Patrick?
Yeah?
Can you see anything?
Not really. Should we move?
So do you know what make it really hate?
What?
Not me just getting off with anyone. Picking off his best mate.
Was Steve?
Yep. You can't do that.
Oh, yeah, and why not? Because it's really evil.
Stop being a bitch, I don't care.
Stop being a lot of it.
And that's why I was electrocuted.
Yeah, and that's why Mike did what he did and thought he could get away with it. Well, fuck him. She could play that game and I'll play it a lot harder than he ever did.
Serious about that, aren't you?
Yeah. Maybe I won't just snog Steve, but fuck him as well.
I slept with that guy, the one that lived with his mum. I told him, I'd go round to his mum's house right now, wake her up and tell her that her son was sucked up in her bedroom, in her bed, twice in one night by a queen. That was him! That was him! Oh,
hi, Steve.
Ali, hi.
Sorry
we didn't get to talk earlier.
That's OK.
You want a drink?
There's something else I wanted, actually.
What are you doing?
I was trying to kiss you.
I'm your boyfriend's best mate.
Ex-boyfriend.
Yeah, well, whatever. I still don't think it's a good idea. You'd kill him.
Yeah, exactly.
Look, I think Mike's behaved like a complete idiot, right? I'm not going to stop liking him just because he made a mistake.
Don't you think I'm attracted?
I think you're beautiful, okay? I'd love to kiss you, and I'd love to sleep with you and feel you next to me when I wake up in the morning, but it's never gonna happen. So if you wanna sleep around, I won't think anything less of you for it. Just leave me out of it, okay?
Sorry.
Hey, thanks for thinking of me.
Well, I always thought you were really sexy anyway.
Really?
Yeah.
I never knew.
Oh, well, I didn't tell you, did I? But I've told you now, so. Are you still friends?
Of course we are.
Must have been entertaining.
For someone to hurt you that much, you must be completely in love with you.
What, you my mum?
Life's a bastard and then you have one?
No, I just want to be left alone, thank you.
All I'm saying is, if you love her like she loves you, then you should be together. And it might not be easy, but you're the only person that's going to make that happen.
Something important in the morning. I bang my head against the pillow before I go to sleep.
You what?
Well, so I want to get up at 6. Before I go to sleep, I bang my head against the pillow 6 times. That means I know I'm going to wake up at 6 o'clock.
Really?
Yeah, it works every time.
Well, what if you want to wake up at 6:30? Well, what if you do get up at 6, but then you go back to sleep? Do you have like a built-in snooze function?
Well,
what if you bang your head too many times by mistake? Do you like go around the 24-hour clock, like back up to 24 and start again? Or can you go backwards with a different kind of bang?
I'm not sure, really.
That sounds pretty silly to me.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Tell you what, I'll make you a deal. I'll let you pierce mine if you let me pierce yours.
You what?
I'll let you pierce my cock if you let me pierce your clit.
Fuck off!
Hey, come on, babe, no pain, no gain.
With a beef burger and your grand sewing needle, I don't think so.
No, I've been thinking about that. See, you could use a sausage. It'd fit much better. What? It would though, wouldn't it? Fit just right, huh?
You idiot.
Oh, come on, Angel, one more time, please. It won't take long.
That's what he said the last time. It took you a bloody hour.
That was stamina.
Look, Danny, I've had a lovely time, but I can't stay. But Terry's going to be back
soon. Terry. Terry will be fine,
mate.
They're old mates.
Yeah, right. You may be old mates, but you won't be old mates for very much longer if he caught you fucking his wife, would he?
Get your fucking eyes tested, wanker! Don't you fucking start. Don't fucking start with me, mate, you understand?
Thank you so much for leaving. I'm really hard, but...
Well, I'm really glad that you didn't do it.
It would have been horrible, wouldn't it?
Yes.
I mean, there's only one solution.
Let's do sunglasses.
Aren't we?
What a twat. Who? It's the sunglasses. Oh, I think it's cool. No, he's not. He's a twat. Who wears sunglasses in a club?
Well, you did a couple of months ago. Seem to remember.
Oh, yeah, well.
There is a distinct paucity of beauty amongst the clientele of this establishment.
They're all as ugly as fuck, if you ask me.
Precisely.
Hey, look. They're kind of sexy.
They're transvestite, stupid.
Yeah, all right, let's do it. Right now. Pierce my cock.
You want to do it?
Yeah, right now, for a change of your mind. Fuck the beef burgers, we can just use a couple of cold tins of lager. We can drink them afterwards, celebrate.
What about the needle?
Sharp as any needle I know. Ow!
Oh, my God, you are a nut of Chas Miller. God, I love you.
Ow, 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 ow! Look, I love you too, Raoul, OK? Just make sure you don't make any mistakes.
Come on.
No, you're not listening, are you?
Karina, you can be so uncouth sometimes.
Well, at least I don't have a fault of giving strange men a blowjob.
Probably make your breath smell better if you did.
You can shut up.
Have you got any colder ones?
No.
Have you got any ice?
What do you think this is? It's not the bloody Ritted Club, a bloody man. What do you expect? The beers are warm, the fridge doesn't work properly, we don't have an ice machine. So what? That's £4, lump it or leave it.
Usually I lump it.
I think I'll leave it.
It's the same hot or cold, it still makes you puke.
No, it's not for drinking. I'm gonna pierce me cock. I've got to numb it first.
Pierce your cock?
Yeah.
Pierce your cock.
Yeah.
Fucking lightweight. I've chopped mine off.
All right, nobody go past that line. Just give me a minute. Back in the cell, eh?
Mosh.
Steady.
Danny in here, is he?
Yeah.
With Angela?
No, I haven't seen Angela at all, mate.
No, you ain't taking acting lessons neither, are you?
Well, I don't have to when I look like Stallone, do I? What, do you think that's funny to you?
Yeah, I'll do as it goes.
Yeah, that'll be £15.
Fuck off.
You're not going to cause any trouble tonight, are you?
Not unless you give me reason to. Now, is Danny in his office, Sly?
No, I think he's upstairs in the bar.
In a helicopter.
A helicopter?
It's a joke, yes.
Oh, right. You mean like a king-sized helicopter?
Yeah, I suppose so.
A jellycopter.
It's a helicopter.
A bellycopter.
A jelly-bellycopter.
A smellycopter.
Get off your nellycopter.
I reckon we've been ripped off.
Really?
Yeah, something should have happened by now.
Well, why don't we go back to the drug dealer and tell him?
Well, demand some more, though, to go to the police. This is stupid.
Well, what should we do then?
Not much we can do, just hang out and see what happens.
We're looking for Izzy's party.
Are you all right?
Yeah.
That's where I'm going.
Oh!
Oh! Oh! Yeah,
let's see where I'm going.
Come on, Tarts, let's make it go!
Listen, no, you lot go on. No, go. I'm going to try and have a quick word with good old-fashioned lover boy over
here. You're just a nasty hoe.
Sweetheart.
Slut.
Proved your point, yeah. No, and you're not one I have. So come on. Oh, come on.
How the fuck do you know I was here?
Don't know. No idea. Are you going to be all right, do you think?
Well, I'll have to, won't I, really?
Well, if it all turns a bit messy, you've got me number, haven't you?
Thanks, Mosh. You're a sweetie.
OK, here goes.
Right. Don't think about it. Just do it. Just be yourself. Be nice.
Yeah, I know.
Fuck. Ali. Ali? What's he doing, Steve?
Don't know.
Feel some puppet.
Hello, Tom. Problem?
Don't you fucking hello tell me, you wanker.
You all right? Don't know what to say, mate. Got it.
Oh! 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 Oh!
See you, yeah? See
you later. You coming out?
No, I've got to go,
Lou.
All right, see
you,
yeah? See you later.
Oh, is she all right?
Yeah, sure, love. Just a bit too much to drink,
that's all. She should stick with the drugs, mate.
I don't know what you mean. Oh. You all right?
No.
Come on, mate, wake up for fuck's sake.
Scared the fucking shit out of me.
You just threatened me with a knife.
You fuck
my wife! Well, you just hit me on the end of the champagne bottle.
Yeah, well, I think you fucking deserved it.
Well...
Yeah. Sorry, mate. I didn't mean to.
You fucking plank.
Excuse me. Are these the men's toilets?
No, they're the girls, but that's all right. They're a bit pongy because someone just bathed everywhere. You want anything?
Kind of. Not really. We did try, though. I think I was sold some duds.
Shit, really? Oh, that's really out of order, that is. Fancy some Charlie?
Some...
Charlie. You know what that is, don't you?
Charlie? Not really, no.
Cocaine? You know what that is, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Have you ever had any before?
No. No, I haven't.
So do you want some? Oh, come on. I'm not going to bite.
Look, you sure you don't want me to come with you? And you got enough money to get home? You know where the taxi rank is? Second on the right is to come out the club. Right, mate. See ya.
Pat, have you ever had any cocaine?
Okay.
No.
What?
Well, this girl in the toilets just gave me some.
You're fucking kidding. Quick, come on, let's find a spot.
Such a horrible thing I did to Mike, wasn't it? No more horror than what he did to you. Oh, God.
Such a bitch.
Only because he's been a complete bastard and probably not even as much as that. Look, you're just getting out of your system. It's okay.
We're never gonna. Part of me was so scared that I was going to spend the rest of my life with him. Another part was so scared that I wasn't.
It's a tricky one, isn't it?
Thank you.
so sorry.
So am I. So sorry. Let me do the talking, okay?
Okay.
Yaz.
Hello.
Hi, my friend was... Well, we were wondering if you've got any more cocaine left.
A few lines, yeah.
Excellent. We can go back to my place and get really fucked.
Well, there's not really enough for three.
No, well, don't worry. It was kind of you to give me some in the first place.
Well, that's all right. That's what it's for, sharing. You can come back to my place if you like. We can finish it off.
Me?
Yeah.
Wow, thanks.
Anthony, I think we should stick together.
Yeah, I suppose so. Wait, hang on. You've arranged to meet that girl.
How did that go?
Yeah, that'll be really great. Thanks very much.
Come on, I was just off.
I'll get in touch with you tomorrow, Matt. See you later.
Bust!
So you're not too pissed off then?
I don't give a stuff no more.
To be perfectly honest, I've been thinking about giving it all up with Ange anyway.
Really? Well, that's a shame. I thought you two got on really well.
Yeah, we do, but... I've been shagging this 20-year-old Australian bird. I've been thinking about immigrating with her.
To Australia? With a 20-year-old? You lucky bastard. Can I come visit?
Yeah, of course you can. Do us a favour. Don't bring Ange.
Jackie!
Are you on E?
Why?
Why are you hugging me then?
I don't know. I just thought it might be a nice idea.
Really?
Yeah, you know, I was wondering if you and me could go back to my flat. You know, just for a smoke.
Oh, just for a smoke?
Yeah, you know, just as friends.
Just as friends?
Yeah.
No.
Come on, people, can you start making a move now, please? Come on, let's move it. Piss off.
Look, I didn't mean what I said before. You know I wouldn't have gone round to your mum's.
Just piss off.
I'm only trying to say I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, I don't want to hear it.
Well, if you don't want to hear that, I was just wondering. Come in.
Oh, come here.
I know I would.
What, back at your place?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Ow! Ow! Oh, God, it hurts, Ron.
When we get home, do you want me to kiss it better for you?
Yeah! Go!
You know, it's nothing to this clubbing game, really. The kids, they come along, they do some drugs, have a drink, have a dance, have a snog if they're lucky, and go back home again. I mean, it's all pretty harmless. But the thing is, people my age, they just can't get the grips of it. They slag it off. They won't give it a chance. But me, I'm different. I walk around my club, I see men and women, black and white, straight and gay, old and young, rich and poor, and all get along fine. And that makes me feel glad to be alive, that does. It's a wonderful feeling. See you tomorrow, when our opening night at the Club Le Monde.
Shining brightly like sunlight inside my mind.